Hey everybody, it's Lon Seidman with another unboxing, and this one came in free of charge through the Amazon Vine program. This is called the F2D Titan, and what it is a traditional film to a digital converter, and it doesn't require a computer to get it done. So it looks like it's got a camera built in, a 20 megapixel camera, they say. Which will take all these different formats and convert them into a digital file. And presumably this might be quicker than using a scanner with a computer. And one of the things that we'll explore in my main review that you'll find at lon.tv is what the image quality is going to look like on here, because what I found is that photo scanning, doing it right, takes a really long time. So we'll see how well this thing is able to maybe speed up that process and make it more efficient. So let's see what we got here in the box. And it looks like it's got some trays here for a couple of different film formats. What I'll probably be doing is scanning in 35 millimeter negatives, but it looks like it even has some trays for those 110 cameras. I had a 110 camera as a kid. Actually, this looks like a 8 millimeter Super 8 insert, so I'm not sure. I don't think it runs like a full film strip, but I guess if you were to run them through a frame at a time, you could probably build a video. Maybe I'll explore that a little bit as well. We've got here, it looks like the 35 millimeter insert perhaps. They have a slide insert, some larger formats also. So lots of different inserts for the different types of film you might encounter along the way. This looks like the power adapter. I think that's what that is. Yep, so we'll leave that be. And here is the main unit itself. Now it has a screen built into it also. So when you're running the film through, you can see what you're doing, which is helpful. And I would guess there's probably some controls for adjusting the focus and maybe hopefully the color perhaps on it also. So we'll see how all of this works. So what happens here, it looks like, is that you put your film in one of these slots here. It'll scan it and put it into a digital file. And there is an SD card slot here on the back. So you put in a card just like you would on a camera. And presumably, again, we'll explore this when we do the full review, it'll spit out a JPEG file, or maybe hopefully something uncompressed that you can then edit later. I'm imagining just JPEG given the price point on this. I don't think this is all that expensive. I'll put a link down below to it in the video description. Also looks like it's got HDMI out here as well for hooking up to a TV set. So looks like it might be pretty simple to operate. We'll see. So stay tuned. We'll be doing a review of this on my main channel at lon.tv in a couple of days. So stay tuned.
This channel is brought to you by my Patreon supporters, including Gold Level supporters Mark Bollinger and Cody Falk. If you want to help the channel, you can by contributing as little as a dollar a month. Head over to lon.tv/Patreon to learn more. And don't forget to subscribe. Visit lon.tv/s.